Yo, what is up? It is your boy Zether here, and this is going to be the finale to the long-awaited series of What If Naruto Had Deadpool's Powers. Now, this series has had an amazing run on my channel, and I'm very grateful to it since it actually is doing very well, since it's actually one of my top popular ones. But sadly, this is going to be the end of the series. If you like the series, go ahead and drop a like down below, you know, to show your appreciation for this. And go ahead and, you know, share this video around, turn your notifications on, subscribe, you know, average YouTube shit. But with nothing else to say, let's go ahead and get started. Now, on the last part, we had left off with Sasuke, Naruto basically taking out the Sound 4, taking out Kinemaru, the Tsunade retrieval mission, and other things like that. Basically, we had left off with Jiraiya offering Naruto a spot to go train with him for the next 3 years. So Naruto would then continue to ask, Jiraiya, could I actually bring Sasuke with me? Which Jiraiya would say, oh yeah, sure Naruto, go ahead, you can bring him. Now after this, they would embark on this 3-year time skip, and Naruto would actually learn Sage Mode, as well as the Rasen Shuriken. He would master teleporting to the point where he could now actually teleport to any given location instead of just where he can see. Plot. And his lightning chakra cloak would actually be increased exponentially, with Naruto actually mastering the Kyuubi and gaining the full Nine Tails abilities, as well as mastering all 5 chakra elements and learning every jutsu there is for them. So, you know what I'm saying? He's going to be a little mini Hiruzen. And he would actually develop more of a tactical fighting style. Being more of a fighter, but a big troll. So, it would go hand in hand. So, it'd be still goofy Naruto, since, you know, Deadpool is a lot of a troll. And Naruto is pretty much a troll, if you could say that. Since he is extremely broken. And, I mean, there's no point for him to go all out at this point. Since, who's really going to stop him? Come on now. Now, as for Sasuke, after a long time, he would actually learn that the curse mark was nothing but a hindrance, that it was not his power. He didn't gain that himself, so he decided to get rid of the curse mark. Now, I'm not even going to go into detail. Let's just say that that happened. He got rid of it, okay? You know, if it happened in canon, it could happen here. So he got rid of it and ended up learning Snake Sage Mode. He would also master all 5 chakra natures and develop his own cloak, if you could say, but it's not going to be a lightning cloak. He actually developed a fire cloak. Now that fire cloak would increase his strength, so since he already has amazing speed, he just wants to get stronger. So the lightning cloak would actually go around him and envelop his fists, arms, you know, all his things. It'll be a very subtle cloak. It won't be nothing crazy. It'll definitely be there and be a 2x booster for his strength, since he took some inspiration from Naruto. Now, Jiraiya, on this time, actually ended up mastering his own Sage Mode, as well as learning the Rasen Shuriken. His procedure was a little slower, and Naruto learned all of these things, as well as Sasuke and Jiraiya, since they kind of spammed the Shadow Clone technique and kind of abused its powers. So that's going to be how they ended up learning them. As for Sakura, same thing as canon, she's still useless. Don't get me wrong, she's still awful. She's still very awful. You know, in this household, we actually like to refer to Sakura as a trash bag. So, go ahead and get on that. Now, this is when Naruto, Sasuke, and Jiraiya would actually arrive back into the village. And after this happens, Naruto would actually climb up on the thing with Sakura and Konohamaru and all of them coming up to greet them. And they all were just kind of like, damn, Naruto, like, you got a little sexy, especially Sakura after she saw him. But, you know, she's still obsessed with Sasuke-kun's dick. So you already know that that's not going to stop her. So she went over to Sasuke and, you know, started trying to get a little bit of that meat. Now, this is when they would inform them of their fruitful training. And Tsunade would actually tell them that they're going to be having a sort of sparring match to see how far they've come in the long time. Now, Jiraiya would actually go up to Tsunade and say, I'm not very sure about that. You do not want to do that. You just take my word for it. Tsunade just being like, what? Like, what is wrong with you, boy? And Jiraiya just kind of being like, facepalming and being like, you'll find out. Now, Kakashi would come in, and this is when Naruto would actually hand Kakashi the new book. and Kakashi would, you know, fangirl and then proceed to go away and read the book. This would leave Team 7 a little bit of time to catch up, and Naruto, Sasuke, Sakura would go out to get some ramen. Now, as this is happening, just gonna go ahead and make up a random ship. What's the ship? Actually, boys, not gonna lie. I don't know if I have even established the ship. If I have, I'm sorry, retcon that. And if I haven't, then I'm just gonna retcon the ship that I already made, and I'm just gonna go ahead and like throw in a ship whenever I feel like it. Honestly, guys, Naruto might not even have a ship. I just don't feel like that's the type of person Naruto is. He doesn't need that. He's gonna have something better. A harem. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and get a sip of water, so I will be right back. Alright, guys, I'm back. Now, they would get ready, and Naruto, Sasuke, and Sakura would actually get ready to face off against Tsunade, Jiraiya, and Kakashi. As the battle starts, Naruto would actually go straight into his lightning cloak and teleport behind Jiraiya, immediately knocking his face straight into the ground, with Jiraiya showing that it was a summoning jutsu. He would then immediately activate his sage mode and start going crazy. Tsunade would see this and wonder if it's really that deep. Now, Tsunade would actually get caught off guard by Sakura punching the ground, and they would then start brawling. As for Sasuke, he would go after Kakashi, and he would turn on his fire cloak. Going very easy at this point. So he and Kakashi would actually throw some very decent hands. This is when Sasuke would then actually look at Naruto. Naruto would just kind of smirk and then say, nod his head. And Sasuke would understand this, and they would both kind of, you know, be done playing these games. Now, as that would happen, Sasuke would actually activate his 3 Tomoe Sharingan. And he would then proceed to activate his fire cloak and go all out on Kakashi. He would pull out all the stops and use his snake sage mode to just show the gap between their powers. Naruto would then jump away from Jiraiya and activate his own sage mode, his lightning cloak. And he would then teleport behind Jiraiya as he then says, good game. And Jiraiya would then kind of like be in fear and like, God damn, this is going to take a long recovery. As Naruto will then go behind Jiraiya and kiss him on the hair. Which Jiraiya will then shoot out his spikes, and Naruto will be like, ah, fuck. Oh my god, Jiraiya, why did you do this? And Jiraiya will then be like, you tried to kiss me, you fag. I'm playing. That would not happen, but Naruto would definitely go in to kiss him on the hair. Just a little bit of a Deadpool moment. And Naruto would then say, okay. He would then activate KCM2 as a giant fucking beast of a Kurama avatar would appear. And Naruto would then look down at Jiraiya and say, meet your doom. As Jiraiya would then say, I forfeit. Kakashi would look up and just be in complete awe. As he then says, yeah, I quit too. And Tsunade will then just be like face palming and then say, well, as we can see, training was definitely fruitful. So she would then declare that everything was fine. Now, at this present moment, Shikamaru and the original team Ino Shikacho would actually be on the mission with Asuma Sensei, and Asuma would die with all of those events going to canon. They would be informed of that, and on the next mission that they were tasked to go on, which would be the killing the Akatsuki members, Naruto would actually decide to go along with them. Now, when he goes along with them, he would decide to just get there on the battlefield. He would then see Kakazu and Hidan. He would then basically have Shikamaru put his faith into him and tell Shikamaru that if he needs any help, he could just, what could he do? Naruto would then look at him and kind of just smile and say, I know you got this, but I'm gonna be heading off to you as soon as I'm done here. But Shikamaru kind of smirking and saying, same old Naruto. Now, as this happens, Naruto will then go into battle and immediately just Rasen Shuriken Kakuzu. I mean, come on now, like, what were you guys expecting? Now, Shikamaru would actually just be about to take out Hidan as Naruto teleports behind him and says, boo! As Shikamaru then gets a little frightened and then ends up throwing his lighter into Hidan's grave. Now, that would happen, and as this mission is happening, actually, Jiraiya will then inform Tsunade that he's gonna go out quest to get on the Akatsuki leader, meaning he would go on the Hidden Rain Village. Now, as this happens, Naruto would actually just be getting back from his mission that he just went on, and would actually find out of the news with Jiraiya going off to kill Pain or find some intel on him. Now, as Naruto returns, he will then kind of be like, not happening. And he will basically teleport straight to Jiraiya right at the last second as Jiraiya was about to get killed. He then comes in and destroys like three Pains and then activates Sage Mode as he stares down at the Pain that can use the pulling. What was that other force? Pulling. You guys are probably thinking I'm a dumbass right now. Probably am, but ugh. You guys know what I'm talking about. Now, he will then come in and speed blitz behind him, not even teleporting, and then smack him across the neck, sending him flying into a crater. Naruto, then seeing Jiraiya in such a condition, would then get immediately angered and activate his KCM2 as he then goes up to him and just starts destroying the Pain. Now, as this is happening, he would then get blinded by his anger and destroy all of them. After this happens, he would then basically realize that there's a chakra path, like there's some chakra nodes, and would decide to pick up Jiraiya, teleport him back to the village, and then teleport straight to the chakra that he was sensing. Now, as he gets there, he would actually end up just killing Naruto and destroying Honan, since what were they gonna do? Nagato was in a very weakened state, and Honan is fodder if she doesn't have prep time. Now, Naruto would actually return back to the Hidden Leaf Village with Sasuke and Naruto, deciding that this is the day that they would go off to find out what happened with Itachi. Now, as this is happening, Killer B would actually get kidnapped by Obito and killed off. But as this is also happening, Naruto and Sasuke would actually be going off to find out what happened with Itachi and to go on to avenge. Now, Sasuke and Naruto would actually run into the Shadow Clone that Sasuke ran into prior, since this is why they actually decided to go off, and would be given the coordinates of the Uchiha hideout. Now, they would inform Lady Tsunade of this, and she would actually just let them go, since she knows there's no stopping them. Now, as this happens, Naruto and Sasuke would actually pull up, and Kisame would be at the door waiting, as he tells Sasuke that he's allowed to walk in, but stopping Naruto. Now, Naruto would actually see Kisame try to stop him, and then say that's pretty funny, as in a blink of an eye, he cuts off Kisame's arm as blood starts to spew out of it, and Kisame just like, when did you? And before he could even finish his sentence, Naruto would then whip out a sword and then just slash his head clean off. Before Kisame even saw anything, he was dead. Now this is when Naruto and Sasuke would actually walk into the hideout, as Naruto then looks at Sasuke and says, if you need help, I'll be here. As Sasuke then walks in and kind of smirks, saying, I won't need it. Now the fight goes on, and he'll activate his 3 Tomoe Sharingan as well as his Sage Mode right off the bat. He will then activate his Fire Cloak, and Itachi would actually have to go all out to pull this victory. Well, to keep up with Sasuke. Originally, he had thought that maybe he would have to hold back, but Itachi was actually extremely impressed. They would actually be going hand-to-hand. The battle would be an amazing battle, with Itachi trapping Sasuke in a genjutsu and Sasuke breaking out. Now, Itachi would try to throw his flaming shuriken, but Sasuke would catch them all in his sword, catching them within the hole of the shuriken, and then would go into rush and knee Itachi right in the head, as Itachi would then reveal its shadow clone, come behind him, and try to place a seal on him to make Sasuke slow down. Now Sasuke would dodge this and come behind of Itachi as he hits him outside of the hideout. Now this is when Sasuke would actually fight hand-to-hand with Itachi, and Itachi would actually gain a bit of the upper hand. As this is happening, Itachi would actually have to activate his Susanoo, and this is when Sasuke would actually have an extremely hard time getting through to it, since he would just be dodging and weaving at this point, as Itachi was actually certain that this is where Sasuke ends. Sasuke then grins and says, you have 5 seconds to release that and tell me why you destroyed the clan, or you will die with the thunderclap. Thunderclap. As Itachi then looks up at the sky to see an extreme amount of chakra building up in the clouds. As he then he then decides to deactivate it, and then says, and then falls to his knees. Wait, no, he doesn't decide to deactivate it. He just falls to his knees from chakra exertion. Sasuke then calls off the lightning dragon and goes up to Itachi and then says, "Why did you do it?" As Itachi then reveals the reason of why everything had happened, why he killed the clan, how he was forced to do everything, and how he had Shisui's eye. Now, as this happens, Sasuke and Naruto would actually be, Naruto would actually approach them, hearing everything that happened. Naruto would be extremely shocked, seeing Itachi there, and both realizing that Itachi had never actually been the bad one. It was Danzo as well as the third Hokage. Now, after this revelation, Sasuke would actually have a sort of tantrum, and he would have everything that he had known previously just broken, and he would pass out. Now, as that happened, Naruto would grab both of them and teleport them straight to Tsunade, as he then tells her to heal them both. Tsunade would just blindly oblige and heal Itachi first. Now, once he's awake, he would then ask Naruto why he saved him, and Naruto would say, "Well, after hearing what happened, I had no reason to consider you a threat." Now, Itachi would then smile at Naruto and say, "Thank him for what he's doing." As Naruto would then say, "I don't need your thanks. I just want you to clear things up." Now, Sasuke would wake up and then say, "I'm gonna kill them!" To which Naruto would then smack him in the back of the neck until he calmed down. Now, Sasuke would get knocked out, and Naruto would then look at Itachi and say, "You need to have a talk with your brother. If all else goes wrong, so you need to use the infinite Tsukuyomi," since, you know, Itachi would have actually told him, not the infinite Tsukuyomi, the Koromatsu Kami on him. Now, Itachi would then kind of nod at him, and this is when he would then reveal everything. Now, things would get cleared up, and Sasuke, Naruto, and Itachi would then go off to kill Danzo. Pretty easy mission. Naruto would just murder him every single time he had with this KCM2 cloak, and he would let Sasuke actually get the final kill. Now, Sasuke would murder him in a very gruesome way. So, rest in peace. I don't know if you guys got that reference, but yeah. Now, they would win, and this is when the Five Kage Summit would actually be announced. Actually, before that, Sasuke and Itachi would actually have swapped eyes, and Sasuke would have actually unlocked his Mangekyo Sharingan after hearing the revelation of Itachi's truth. Now, they would switch eyes and both gain the Eternal Mangekyo, with them both, with Itachi actually getting his perfect Susanoo, and Sasuke learning how to use it during this time. Now, at this time, the Five Hokage Summit would actually be announced, and Naruto would be told to go off with Tsunade. Now, everything would go the same until the Raikage gets a little angry and starts blaming the villages for what's going on. Now, Naruto would get very angered by this, and then stand up and say, "You need to calm down." The Raikage would then say, "You need to calm down, brat. You don't know who you're talking to." As Naruto would then activate a lightning cloak, way more powerful than the one the Raikage has. As the Raikage A would just sit down in his chair, angry. Naruto would then go to say something, but before he could do anything, Madara, or as we know, Obito would appear, declaring the fifth Great Shinobi War. Now, as this happens, Naruto tries to speed blitz him, but Obito gets away, barely phasing through. Now, the original events with Kanon, with all the original fights, Sasuke going off with Itachi, destroying Kabuto, all of that would go up to Kanon. Now, things would ultimately stay the same up until Naruto actually gets on the battlefield with Obito. Now, they would have an amazing battle, with Obito actually having an amazing advantage, if you could call it that. Like, he would have died way earlier on if it wasn't for his ability to phase through things. Now, Naruto and Sasuke would actually gather up as Sasuke returns to the battlefield, along with Itachi actually there. Now, as that happened, Naruto, Sasuke, and Itachi would actually proceed to start trying to fight Obito, with Obito honestly not knowing what to do. This is when Madara would then appear in the battlefield, and as that happens, Naruto would actually realize that this is going to be a little more of a problem than they had originally thought. Now, after that, they would go on to fight with Madara, with Itachi taking on Madara and Sasuke, and Naruto taking out Obito. The fight would continue, and it would actually go on for a couple of hours now. Naruto would actually come out victorious against Obito, meaning no Kakashi versus Obito fight here. And he would actually have had to pull out all the stops. KCM2, Lightning Chakra Cloak, and I'm just going to go ahead and buff Obito. He has one of the Rinnegan at this point, and he was using the powers correctly this time. So it was a very, very evened out-ish fight, you could say. The only reason Obito didn't die beforehand was because of his Kamui ability. As for Madara, things weren't that easy on that side. Madara would have actually tried to summon the Ten Tails and get them off guard, but Naruto would then appear and seal Madara away with the Uzumaki chains that I gave him just now because I felt like it. He would teleport behind Madara, smack him away as he says, "Wow, you are really some urban legend, aren't you?" With Madara being angered and thinking, "How is this kid this powerful?" Now that fight would ravage on for about a minute, with Naruto basically speed blitzing Madara and basically throwing him around in the fashion that Mike Guy did it in the original canon. Now, Naruto would have his fun with Madara and then decide that it was over. But then seal him away with the chains, as I established previously, and that would mark the end to the third Great Ninja War. Or was it fourth? I don't know. That doesn't matter. Now, that would mark the end to the war. And Naruto, Sasuke, and Itachi would actually head off, being known as the Great Heroes for basically single-handedly taking out the war. And that's basically it. Neji survives. Most of the people who ended up dying actually don't die, and things actually end up a lot better for the villages. Now, I paused the video just for that noise to stop, and it keeps going. Sorry for any background noise that was in this video. You know, it's out of my control. But yeah, now, after the war ends, Naruto is basically known as a hero throughout the land. The one who defeated Madara, Obito, Sasuke, and Itachi are praised along the village, with Itachi basically just ending things off, being single. Sasuke ends up marrying Ino, because fuck Sakura. And Naruto basically just ends up being, you know, a Deadpool sort of person and just being with every single kunoichi that he could find. And that's how Naruto ended. He ended up having multiple kids, and you know, one of those got to be Boruto. So yeah, also disclaimer guys, I'm not getting into Boruto, I'm not getting into the Ten Tails, none of that. It's just not happening. Also forgot to mention the fucking Sage of Six Paths didn't even give them their powers yet. That's how OP Naruto is. Now, I'm just gonna go ahead and give like a brief discussion of what would happen if like the Momoshiki guys or all that came in. Naruto would cock slap. As for manga, that one Otsutsuki probably kill Naruto. Naruto would probably, no, actually Naruto can't die, so probably be in a bit of a situation. Sage of Six Paths would give him his powers, then he would get mollywopped. The end. Now, that's gonna mark the end and the conclusion to what if Naruto had Deadpool's powers. I hope you guys enjoyed the run. I know I sure did. I had a lot of fun making this series, a lot of good moments. But without any further ado, Zether.